Good morning. Let's discuss about how can we create block codes. In the previous classes, we discussed what are block codes and how to encode or how do we get block codes and the generator circuits. Then we also said how to make use of block codes for error detection and correction. And finally, we have also spoken about error detection as well as correction circuit in hardware, and also about the error detection and correction capabilities of block codes. So what are the capabilities? For which we defined the Hamming weight of a code, which is the minimum number of ones. The total number of ones in a given code vector is its Hamming weight. The distance between two code vectors is the number of bits in which the two code vectors differ from each other. And for a given code, if we take pairs of code vectors, we can find the minimum distance of a code as the smallest difference between two code vectors in that given code. So between a pair of two code vectors, which is the smallest distance obtained, that would be the minimum distance. Finding that minimum distance is very important. We can either find it using the regular method by computing the smallest Hamming weight in a given set of code vectors belonging to the same code, or by using the addition of columns in the H matrix. We have the parity check matrix. The minimum number of columns to be added to get all zero column, that number tells you what is the minimum distance of a code. All these techniques we saw, and along with that we saw the error detection capability of a linear block code is obtained as d minimum minus 1, and the error correction capacity will be d min minus 1 by 2. So with all this background, let's try to move on to how we can create block codes. Block codes are specified by n comma k. The code takes k information or message bits and computes n minus k parity bits or check bits from a code generator matrix. Okay, and totally we will be having n bits in the code vector of the block code. Most block codes are systematic in that the information bits remain unchanged with parity bits attached either to the beginning or to the end of the information sequence, right? We call them as systematic codes. Let's move on to designing single error correcting Hamming codes. I told you, because Hamming was the main person who devised many of the characteristics of these codes, they got the name as Hamming codes. Let's move on to understand what are single error correcting Hamming codes. Hamming code is the first class of linear block codes devised for error correction. The single error correcting Hamming codes are characterized by the following parameters. The code length is given as 2 power m minus 1. How did we get this code length? Generally, this is because we know the H transpose matrix has how many rows and how many columns? N rows into n minus k columns. Yes or no? There will be n rows in the H transpose matrix and n minus k columns. Now, if each row should correspond to one error in one particular bit, one bit error, row one means error in the first bit, row two is error in the second bit, so on. That's how we identified, right? So every row corresponds to error in different bit positions, then all these rows of the H transpose matrix should be unique. If I should have all rows to be unique with n minus k bits in each row, how many different unique combinations are possible with n minus k bits, sorry, in each row, 2 power n minus k different combinations are possible, right? So we know we are writing the bits in the data in binary. So if I have n minus k bits in every row, I'll have 2 power n minus k different combinations possible, of which all zero combination indicates no error. So it should not be there in the H transpose matrix. It should not be there in H transpose, right? In H transpose, I should have only those rows which will correspond to errors in different bit positions, single bit positions. So if I remove the all zero value, how many total number? Therefore, now total number of unique combinations, total number of unique combinations are 2 power n minus k minus 1. So this many unique combinations are possible with n minus k bits in every row. In that case, therefore, the total number of rows in H transpose, therefore, total rows in H transpose n should be, we know that a H transpose has n rows, n should always be less than or equal to 2 to the power of n minus k minus 1. So this is how we got this condition. Here, if you notice, we have written m as n minus k. So n should be less than or equal to 2 to the power of n minus k minus 1. I hope you understood how we got this. Every row of H transpose has n minus k bits. With n minus k bits, I can have 2 to the power of n minus k different combinations possible, out of which the all zero combination represents the no error syndrome. So it won't be there in H transpose. So removing that one combination, now I'm left with 2 power n minus k minus 1 total number of combination, which yields n value to be less than or equal to. So the total number of unique rows in H transpose, each row should specify error in one bit position, that n should be less than or equal to this value. Okay, the total number of unique combinations. Similarly, the number of information bits can be defined as 2 to the power of n minus k minus n minus k minus 1. Or in other words, if I continue this, let me isolate k from this. To find k, what should I do? Take log n. I'll take log n on both sides, log n to the base 2. This side, log 2 power n minus k to the base 2 minus 1. Right? So what would this yield? This would give me, I can shift this one to the left hand side before itself. That would make it easier. So I'll make it log n plus 1 here. Okay. Sorry. Yeah. So n has been shifted to the left hand side and then we've taken the log. So what would the right hand side be? It would just give you n minus k. And what are we interested in? We are interested in k. You say therefore k will be less than or equal to n minus, I'll shift this to the right hand side, log n plus 1 to the base 2. So this is another way of defining k. You can say k should be less than or equal to n minus log n plus 1 to the base 2. Here n should be less than or equal to 2 power n minus k minus 1. These are different ways of specifying n and k. Here n minus k is called as m. And the most important thing what you should remember is the error detection capacity would be d-min. The error detection capacity of this code would be equal to d-min. And the error correction capacity of this code will be 1. Because we are talking about single error correcting codes. Single error correcting means t. The error correction capacity should be 1. And if you remember, how do I find t? T is found as d-min minus 1 by 2. Only if d-min value is 3, I will get t as 1. So these single error correcting Hamming codes will be capable of detecting 3-bit errors. So even if 3 bits are in error, they'll be able to detect those 3-bit errors, but they will be able to correct only single bit errors. Okay. So the parity check matrix of this code will consist of all non-zero m tuples as its columns. In systematic form, the parity check matrix, the columns of H will be arranged like this. Q appended with IM, IM or IK, anything you can call. It's the identity matrix. And the matrix Q will contain, it's nothing but the transpose of the parity matrix. So Q is nothing but the P transpose. The standard definition, whatever we had taken, P transpose and I n minus k. Sorry, I n minus k this should be. This would be the standard definition of the H matrix. And so we need three parity check symbols and for the value. Let's come to this problem a bit later. We can see that we can have combinations like 7,4, 15,11, 31,26, 63,57. All these are single error correcting Hamming codes. And each and every one of them are quite useful for many applications. Okay. Another important property of Hamming codes is that they normally satisfy the Hamming bound condition with the equal to sign. You remember what is that Hamming bound condition? We saw Hamming bound here is 2 power n minus k should be greater than or equal to summation ncj, where j ranges from 0 to t, right? So if this condition is satisfied with equality sign, then we call them as perfect codes. All the single error correcting Hamming codes are binary perfect codes. Remember that. And there is a chance that we can get shortened Hamming codes by deleting L columns from the parity check matrix of the Hamming code. Normally, we have a special category of codes known as repetition codes. And there we normally shorten. We can remove certain columns in the parity check matrix and shorten the length of the code. And they are known as shortened Hamming codes. And the parameters of the shortened Hamming codes are as shown below. So the code word length will be less than or equal to 2 power n minus k minus L. So this is 2 power n minus k minus L minus 1. We used to have just 2 power n minus k minus 1 for actual Hamming code, single error correcting Hamming code. Here a minus L will come into picture because we are removing L columns in the parity check matrix. So naturally the transpose of the parity check matrix will also lose L rows. That means I'll be able to correct lesser number of errors. That's why the length of the code is also less. K as usual, and n minus k, we called it as m. Here, the minimum distance of the code should be more than 3. Minimum for single error correcting, it is 3. Here, it should be more than or equal to 3. With this, In order to design a single error correcting Hamming code, we have to see how to create a parity matrix. So, or the H transpose matrix. Rather than parity matrix, we'll say how to create the H transpose matrix for a linear block code. So what are we supposed to do? Say, I'll take an example. Say, for example, if we are using 7,4 code. Here, n is 7, k is 4, right? Therefore, n minus k is 3. Therefore, H transpose matrix has each row with how many columns? N, each row having n minus k columns, right? Therefore, which is 3 columns in each row according to the example what we have taken. Therefore, total rows possible is 2^3, which is 8, minus 1, because what? All zero row should be eliminated. Eliminating the all zero row, 7 rows are possible. So what should I do? I start listing, list all possible, what? 3-bit combinations. So how many 3-bit combinations you start listing? We are familiar with this. 0 0 0 0 0 1 0 1 0 1 1 1 0 0 1 0 1 1 1 0 and 1 1 1. I have listed all 8 possible 3-bit combinations. Out of this, for parity matrix, what and all I shouldn't have? For the parity matrix, the condition is all zero should not be present. Next, elements of identity matrix should not be present. What are the elements of the identity matrix here? So all zero should not be present because it indicates a syndrome of no error. It won't be there in H transpose. Identity matrix will have elements like 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. So even those elements should be eliminated because we are going to append an identity matrix in the end. So if I remove the elements of the identity matrix, whatever is left, that can be written in any different combinations to form the parity matrix. Now, list the remaining elements. List the remaining elements. To form P matrix. So here, and they can be listed in how many elements are left? 1, 1, 2, 3, 4. So I can have 4 factorial different ways of listing them. So I can either write 0, 1, 1 in the same order, what is left? 1, 0, 1. 1 1 0 and 1 1 1 would be the parity matrix, or I can reverse it. Say 1 1 1 1 1 0 1 0 1 0 1 1. Many possible ways are there of grouping these. I can order these 4 rows in any different ways, right? So I can make different permutations and change it in 4 factorial different ways of rearranging. So this is how the parity matrix is obtained. And from this, if I have to get the H matrix, what would H matrix be, or H transpose? It will be parity appended with IN minus K. In the sense, the parity matrix, whatever we have formed, you list that. And to this, I have to append the identity matrix 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. So this completes the H transpose matrix. Okay. So please remember, finding parity matrix is quite simple, provided you know what to eliminate. The all zero value should be eliminated, and the rows present in an identity matrix should be eliminated. So whatever is left, they can be written in any different way, and everything is correct. Depending on what length you need, you choose. Since I need the parity matrix to have k rows and n minus k columns, please remember all this. 4 rows and 3 columns. I'll choose all the remaining 4 combinations of this 3-bit vectors. So the parity matrix is formed. To get the H transpose matrix, I just have to append the identity matrix I n minus k below this. Okay. So this is how we create the parity matrix. Here we have shown some examples for the same thing. See, we have another ordering possible. All ones 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1. I can have different ordering possible. There are 4 factorial ways in which you can order. Here in the next example, this is another different way of ordering. 111, 110, 101, whatever we had done here. In this case, we had done that, right? Either this or this, any different ordering will give you H transpose. This is H transpose. Now, if I have to get the generator matrix from this, I can just take the parity matrix. We know generator is composed of what? Identity matrix of order k into parity matrix. So I just have to write an identity matrix of order 4 and append the parity matrix which we have written here. This will be your parity matrix. Append that here. This would give you the generator. Okay. So let's look at some example problems now. Let's take this example. Design an n minus k Hamming code with d minimum as 3 and message length of 4 bits. So what is given? Given d minimum is 3 and k is 4 bits. Also show that it can correct single errors in the received vectors. Okay. So our first job is to find what is the value of n. We know the value of k. So using the condition, what is the condition? N should be less than or equal to 2 to the power of n minus k minus 1. Right. So what should we do? How do I apply the condition here? I have to choose by trial and error. By trial and error, let's say, let n be 5. Since k is 4, I'll start considering from the next higher value after k. If n is 5, then check in the inequality. 5 should be less than 2 power 5 minus 4 minus 1, which is not true. This will not be true because this becomes 2 minus 1. 5 is not less than 1. Next, put n as 6 and check. Is 6 less than 2 power 6 minus 4 minus 1? Again, 2 power 6 minus 4 will give you 2 square minus 1, which is 3. So 6 is not less than 3. It is not true. Put n as 7 and check. 7 less than 2 power 7 minus 4 minus 1, which means this is 2 cubed minus 1, or 8 minus 1 is 7, right? This satisfies. On the left hand side also I have 7. On the right hand side also I have 7. So n value can be taken as 7. Therefore n should be 7 and k is given as 4. The Hamming code which we have to design should be having n as 7 and k as 4. Now, let's find the parity matrix. We have already done this example. To find P, what should I do? P should be what? List all possible combinations of 3-bit numbers. 7 minus 4 is 3. So list all possible 3-bit numbers and eliminate those which are present in the identity matrix and keep the rest arranged in any order, right? So 101 110 111. This is not used. All identity, these four can be used. You arrange it in any order. I'll say let P be 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1. This let this be our parity matrix. Okay, now if this is our parity matrix, we can write the generator matrix. I'll write, therefore G is what? I4P, identity matrix of order 4, followed with parity matrix which we have obtained just now, 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 0 and 1 1 1. So this is our generator matrix. He has also asked us to verify whether dmin is 3. So if I have to check dmin, let me get the H matrix. Therefore, H matrix would be, so this is a 4 cross 7. H matrix would be what? P transpose IN minus K. So P transpose means I have to take the transpose of these elements 0, 1, 1. 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 and followed with identity matrix of 3 elements, right? So this is I3 and this is P transpose. This has order N minus K cross N or 3 cross 7, as you can notice. Now you add the columns of H to find dmin. I can add C1 column 1 plus C2. What do you get? C1 plus C2. It would be 0 1 1 plus 1 0 1, which will give you 1 1 0. And this we'll add it to C3. C3 is 1 1 0. Now I'm getting the all 0 column. So how many columns have I added? 1, 2, 3. Therefore, 3 columns are to be added to get the all 0 value. Dmin value is 3, which satisfies our initial condition. And lastly, he asks, show that this can correct single bit errors. So the number of errors corrected is given as dmin minus 1 by 2. Which will be 3 minus 1 by 2, which is 1. To prove that it can correct single bit errors, what should I do? I have to assume a received vector with 1 bit in error. Okay. To prove that it can correct single bit errors, assume R1 received vector with 1 bit in error. Let me consider something like this. I have taken the all 0 code vector and I have made the first bit to be in error, assuming 1 bit error. Now, compute syndrome. To show that it will correct and identify that error, you compute the syndrome S1 as R1 into H transpose. So when we do this, R1 is like this, this into H transpose would be 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. So when I multiply this, you check what you'll get. I told you row into column, you have to multiply. So the first bit position would be 1 into 0. You check whether the 1 matches. 1 is in the first bit here. This is a 0. It doesn't match. And all other positions are 0. So you'll get a 0. The second bit position is a 1. So you'll have a 1. Third bit in the first bit position is again a 1. So I'm going to get the multiplication of this vector with this matrix as 0, 1, 1. Now, matching with H transpose, matching with H transpose rows, which row matches? First row matches, right? So you see, first row matches with the syndrome S1. Therefore, first bit of R1 from left is in error, right? And what is that first bit? It is 1. You just toggle that bit, you'll get the correct vector. Therefore, corrected code vector C1 cap will be all 0 code vector. See, we had assumed all 0 code vector only to have error in one bit position. And now, using the general detection and correction principles, we are able to prove that it will be able to detect the position of error and also correct it. I told you correction can be done either by toggling the bit position after identifying which row matches, or by using an error vector, define an error vector with 1 in that particular bit position and add this to the received vector to get the corrected code vector. Any one can be done. So this solves our problem. Okay, the problem what we took in this example. One more example we can take. Design a single error correcting Hamming code. It should be a Hamming code with message block size of 11. K is 11. Show that it can correct single error with an example. Find G and H matrices of this code. So if K is 11, you have to find N. How do you find N? N is less than or equal to 2 power N minus K minus 1. And let N be, let me take N as 12. See if 12 is less than or equal to, this will be 12 minus 11 minus 1. It doesn't satisfy. N is 13. 13, is it less than or equal to 2 to the power of 13 minus 11 minus 1? This is also 3. It doesn't satisfy. N is 14. Is 14 less than 2 power 14 minus 11 minus 1? So this is 2 cubed minus 1. 14 is not less than 7. N is 15. Is 15 less than 2 power 15 minus 11? Minus 1, 2 power 4 is 16, minus 1 is 15. So the condition is satisfied at this point. Therefore, N is 15 and K is 11 in this given code. Okay. So if N is 15 and K is 11, what should we have for how many bit combinations in the parity matrix? Therefore, for P, we should have 2 to the power of 4 different combinations to choose from, right? I have to write, there will be 4 bits in the columns. So list all the 4 bit combinations. You have all zeros, which will not be used. It won't be part of the parity or H transpose. 0, 1, not used because it will be there in identity matrix. 1, 0, not used. 1, 1, can be used. 0100 not used, single ones. 0101 can be used. 0110, 0111, and likewise 1000 cannot be used. Wherever I have single ones, surely they belong to the identity matrix. 1001, 1010, 1011, 1100, 1101, 1110, 1111. All these can be used. Therefore, we'll write the parity matrix in the next. I have to use only these particular combinations which have more than a single ones, and all zero should be eliminated. So for a 15,11 code, how many rows should I have? For 15,11, the P matrix will have 11 rows into 15 minus 11, or which is 4 columns, right? So you list the parity matrix. I have to write 11 rows means how many rows have we eliminated here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have eliminated 5 rows. All the remaining 11 rows have to be included in any order which you want. You can include all the remaining 11 rows as starting with say 0011, 0101, 0110, 0111, 1001, 1010, 1011, 1100, 1101, 1110, 1111. So I have used all 11 combinations here. You can count and see it is 11 combinations. This will be our parity matrix. Therefore, how do I write the generator matrix? Generator matrix will be IK/P. That is I11/P. You have to list a generator of what? 11 rows and 11 columns. So you write a generator matrix. You can write it completely. 11 rows and 11 columns. To this, I will append the parity matrix which we have written here. 0101, all this 1111. So this will be our generator matrix. You'll be awarded marks for this also. You are also supposed to list the parity check matrix. H should be P transpose IN minus K, which will be what? 4 rows into 15 columns. So take the transpose of this matrix. 0011, 0101, 0110. Likewise, 1111. I am done with P transpose. Now I should write what? IN minus K. Here, IN minus K, which is I 4. 15 minus 11 is 4. So list an identity matrix of order 4. This will give you your parity check matrix. So they have asked you to find the G and H matrices of this code and show that it can correct single bit error with an example. So how will I show that it will correct single bit error? To show that one bit error is corrected, first I have to find is corrected. You have to first find dmin. Find dmin by adding what? Columns of the, by adding columns of the H matrix. You will find that dmin will be 3. If I list this H matrix completely, you will know that if I add three columns, I'll be able to get zero. Okay. Till you get the all zero value, you should add. If I add three columns, I'm going to get the all zero value. You can check out with combinations C1, C2 and C3 will give you the all zero value. Okay. Therefore, the error correcting capacity will be dmin minus 1 by 2, which is 1. Also, like how we did last time, let a received vector RA be. I'll assume the all 0 with a 1 in a single bit position. Remember, it should have 15 bits. N value is 15, 4, 8, 12. So this is the received vector. Now, syndrome is obtained as RA into H transpose. And if you multiply this with transpose of this H matrix, surely you will get the value as 0110, because in your H transpose, you will have P and IN minus K. The P what we have written is 0011101010110111, likewise, right? So I know I have induced an error in the third bit position. So naturally the third row of H transpose should match with the syndrome. So syndrome should be same as third row. So you can say, even without calculating, you can directly write all these things. That's what I'm telling. Matches with third row of H transpose. Since this is a very big matrix, you can easily do it without calculating. Therefore, error pattern, you can write error pattern EA as 001 followed with all zeros. Therefore, corrected code vector CA cap is RA plus EA, which will give me the all zero code vector. Hence proved that single bit errors can be corrected, right? Hence proved that one bit errors can be corrected. Okay. So let's stop with this and let's move on to the lookup array in the next class. Thank you.